Still ahead, Bill Smead predicts which stocks will rebound first on Bulls and Bears. Bill Smead is founder and CEO of Smead Capital Management and portfolio manager of the Smead Value Fund. He joins us each week to demystify the stock market. Good to have you here, Bill. I'm talking about what's going to bounce back first. And, you know, let's face it, not everyone's going to know. But what do you think is going to do well first?
I like to go by history. And the history is whoever was doing well despite the difficult circumstances, has a tendency to attract the most capital early on.
Such as?
Well, Verizon reported that their profits grew 15% in the fourth quarter. That's pretty outstanding. Big cell phone growth, lots of use. People are using their cell phones for a lot of different reasons. AT&T had big earnings increase in the cell phone division, but took some write-offs, and so their profits contracted, but they also saw incredible growth in cellular. So traditionally, when people are done being very, very fearful, they first go to the most reliable things. Drug companies would be another where the Mercks and the Amgens of the world would gain favor because they have been doing relatively well. Their earnings aren't down 50 or 70% temporarily. They might be down a little bit or maybe growing 5 or 10%.
Plus, people are still getting older as a population. People will still get sick and need treatment, so that's a good bet.
All those things that everyone will care about when we come out of this coma, right? The thing you just mentioned, that's exactly the kind of thing that people are normally thinking about as investors, but right now they're so fearful they can't think of the things that really matter most over the next 5 or 10 years.
That's interesting that you mentioned coma. It's like people are stuck, you know, they're afraid to make any bold moves. What's going on?
Tony Shearer works with us, and he came up with an analogy the other day I thought was fabulous. He said that when people go into the hospital and are in a coma, that when they come out of the coma, they will tell friends and relatives, I could hear you speaking to me while I was in the coma. And that's what we feel like right now. We're speaking to investors. They're in a coma, and they're hearing us, but they won't act until they come out of their coma. And the securities world, the New York Stock Exchange and the Dow Jones Industrial Average traditionally are the leader out of great difficulty. That's the first, it can be a year before the economy turns historically when the stock market takes off. And that's an anticipatory kind of a thing. So it goes right with that analogy.
President Obama's stimulus package. I think it's safe to say that our region will probably benefit, you know, from the money that's going towards the creation of jobs. I mean, there are public works projects maybe in the works, the new 520 bridge, maybe new viaduct or tunnel to replace the viaduct. Do you think that that bodes well for like construction industry, building industry, things like that, and stocks in those areas?
I think it's a positive accident. And what I mean by that is, there's a lot of infrastructure that needs to be taken care of around the country. And if this is the circumstance that caused us to deal with it, I think that's great. On the other hand, do I think that that's the right way to get things going? No. I think that, for example, if they told everyone that made a new investment this year, that they would get grandfathered and be free of capital gains taxes on the investments they make this year, that would stimulate someone. If they could buy a stock and know they didn't have to pay a tax on the gain if they held it for 5 or 10 years, that would cause a lot of people maybe to sell poor performing investments they're sitting on and go buy something with a bright future. Get people to start moving again. And so I'd like to see some of those kind of proposals kick into gear. Give people positive incentives to do something that draws them out of that coma we were just talking about, and I think that would have more of an impact. On the other hand, I'm glad that we're going to fix the bridges and fix the viaduct. I'm glad we're going to do those things, but those are long-tail stimulative things. Those take 3 or 4 years to really have their full impact, and what we'd like to do is draw people out of the coma in the next 6 months. That's what we'd really like to do.
Retail has been hammered this year. You know, bad Christmas for a lot of companies. How long do you think that'll take before they start coming out of it?
That's another traditional early cycle group, ironically. Ironically, if the market somewhere in here in the next 3 to 6 months decides we're going to come out of this, they will focus on the retailers because people will buy something first And then if they buy something from the retailers, then it has to be made by whoever provides it to them. So in line, retail first, manufacturer of what retail sells second.
Yeah, gotcha. Right? Or what about Boeing? I mean, we talked earlier in the show about the 10,000 layoffs. Mm-hmm. How do you think its stock will do?
Well, Boeing is a very long cycle company, makes a very expensive item, and sells to companies that you and I have discussed before that I've never been able to figure out why it all works. The answer is, I don't own it, but they're probably a buy-in here, and their financial strength carries them through. And those cycles are hard to figure out. Yeah. And I've never been one that would admit that I've been able to figure those out. But more than likely, this is a good time in the cycle to be a buyer of Boeing.
All right. Thank you very much, Bill. Good advice, and we'll see you next week.
You're welcome.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
Next week on About the Money, we'll look for hope and new beginnings amid the gloom of the recession. Find out why a popular Seattle chef is opening a hip new restaurant.
You know, I don't think you can live your life in fear. I think you need to plug forward. I think it's time to batten down the hatches.
And ask what President Obama's promise of change will mean for your retirement fund.
Plus, Attorney General Rob McKenna with tax time tips to protect you from identity theft. And Bill Smead with help for investors, all next week. Thank you for watching. And to the members of KCTS 9, thank you so much for your financial support. We wouldn't be here without you. If you haven't joined yet, there's no time like the present. It's easy to join online at kcts9.org. Or give us a call at 1-800-937-5287. See you next week. Keep your chin up. And remember, it's all about the money.
Production of About the Money is made possible in part by Russell Investments, a global provider of asset management, retirement investments, mutual funds, and indexes. Russell works with advisors and institutions of all sizes. Learn more at russell.com. And by the Washington State Department of Financial Institutions, helping consumers make educated financial decisions about saving and investing, buying a home, or with concerns about debt or investment scams. Invest wisely. Save wisely. Educate yourself. And by KCTS 9 members. Become a member today by going to kcts9.org. Thank you.